guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. And in this tutorial I want to show you guys how to calculate the area of a piece of land by coordinates in Excel. So let me just show you in Google Earth. So this is a piece of land that I'm going to use this as an example. So I've already plotted this one in Civo 3D. Already have this one in Civo 3D, and also have it in PDF. So now you can see we have this particular piece of land, and we have the corner points. That's G25, G26, 69NE and 69NW. So we want to calculate the area of this particular piece of land in Excel using coordinates. So already have the coordinates of this corner points, and you can use the same formula that I'm going to show you to calculate the area of any particular polygon that you want to calculate. So let me just open the Excel. So this is the Excel that contains the coordinates. Let me just arrange my work now. So these are the coordinates. These are the coordinates of these stations. You have point G26, 69NE, and 69NW. So then you have the corresponding coordinates. So we are going to use these coordinates to calculate the area. Now, you just pay close attention. So what we are going to do now down here, let me just copy the headings. So if you want to use this example to do some practice, I'll copy a link where you can download this kind of Excel so that you can use as an example. So now just pay close attention. I want to explain a very important point. So what we're going to do, we are going to move from point G25. We're going, you can start from any point. You can start from G26, you can start from G69NE. So we're going to type these coordinates right here, but we're going to type them sequentially. This is by sequentially mean that we're going to move, if you're going to start from this point, we are going to move like this, and this one, then back to this one, then move one step ahead. If you're going to start from 26 or 25, we're going to do the same. Move from 25, go to 26, 69 NE, 69 NW, and then back to G25 and close. So as I said, let me type in. We're going to start, for me I'm going to start from G25, and as well you can move, you can choose to move in an anti-clockwise direction or a clockwise direction, it doesn't matter. So we just follow closely. So I said I'm going to start with G25, so I'm going to type in G25, and this one is not so G25, and then we're going to move to station G26. So G26, then next we're going to move to 69NE, and then we're going to move to 69NW, then move to back to G25, and then move one step. We have already closed, but we're going to move to the next so that we can then type just G26 to close. Now we are going to copy the code, the nothings. These are the nothings. We are going to copy all the nothings. Let me just add another cell like that so that to get some space or some room. So we have nothings. We are going to copy all the nothings, then we move to easting. Let me just copy. I'm going just to copy G25. Control V, G26, nothing, copy, paste, 69NE, copy, then paste, 69NW, nothing, copy. And you have to be very careful, guys, otherwise we will find ourselves messing things up. So copy G25, the nothings, and then lastly let's just copy G26, the nothings. Now things are now going to get interesting, because the easting, we're not going to copy all the eastings of these stations. We are going to skip G25 and we're going to start from G26, 69NE, 69NW, G25 alone. We're not going to copy the eastings of G25 and G26 at the bottom. So again, we're going to copy the easting of G26. So this is the easting. Copy. Control C, Control V. The easting of 69NE. Copy. Control C, Control V. The easting of 69NW, 69NW. Copy. Paste. Then lastly, easting of G25. Copy. Then paste. So now in this area we are going to now do some calculations. Let me just, I hope not having any problem. So now on this cell, this cell here, we're going to calculate the easting, the nothing of G25, or the nothing of 69NE, this one here, we're going to subtract from the nothing of G25, then we multiply by easting of G26. Hope we're seeing the logic. Let me just do the first one. So in order to write a formula in Excel, you start with equals. So just click equals and then bracket equals to, I've said the nothing of 69NE, then minus the nothing of G25, like that, close. Then we are going to multiply by the easting of G26. Like that. Nothing of G69NE minus nothing of G25 multiplied by the easting of G26, because it's in between G25 and 69NE. Then click enter. So you can just, let me do the second one, then you can drag down the formula, you can copy down the formula. So you can, so the next one equals to the nothing of, first of all just type in the bracket, so this one is in between 69NW and G26, so we are going to subtract the nothing of G26 from 69NW, then we multiply by the easting of the station that is in between, that is 69NW. So that is nothing of 69NW minus G26, close the bracket, multiply by the easting of the station that is in between, that is 69NE. Click enter. So you can drag down. So let's see. Yes, formula is correct. So hope we have seen like that. So like this one, B16 is the nothing of G26 minus the nothing of 69NW multiplied by the easting of the station that is in between, and that is G25. So that is it. Now that we have done that, now at the bottom here, just write 2, just write 2 area, or 2 area, that is to show that whatever that we're going to calculate here, we're going to add all this one. So whatever that we're going to find here, it is the area of that polygon multiplied by 2. So this is, let's just make these boxes here bold. And like that. Now, the next steps, we're going to add everything in this, whatever that we have calculated in this section. So just write equals to, then bracket, this one, or just write equals to sum, then drag down all this, whatever that we've calculated, close the bracket and click enter. Now we're getting this kind of answer, but don't, it's in negative, but don't worry, that's not whatever that the area that we're going to get, we're going to assume that it's in positive. So the next cell, that is A. Now A equals to A will be equivalent to whatever that we've calculated here divided by 2. So this one, right, equals to 2A divided by 2. So this is the area, and so in order to get positive, let me just close that and then multiply by negative 1 to get positive. So this is the area in square meter squared. So our area, so the area, let me just write area equals to, so this one equals to, and then this is in meter squared, and meter squared. So I don't know where subscript is, but I can just right click, format, then superscript, this one. So so this is the area of this particular polygon. So this is the area of this polygon, and we've used the coordinates to calculate that. So in order to prove this, this is the correct answer, let me just open my calculator. And as you can see, the bearings, and all the bearings, so this is perfect 90 degrees, 180, 70, 0 degrees. So it shows you that this is a perfect rectangle. So, and in order to calculate area of a rectangle, you normally do that area is equals to length times width. So we can as well just write here, so area equals to, so area equals to L times width. Let me just use caps. L times width. Area, sorry, times width, some space. So which means that area equals to width, length is 60.96 multiplied by 27.43. So we're getting the same answer. Let me just use that 60. So as you can see from our calculator, 60.96 multiplied by 27.43. So, and this is the answer. So the area of this polygon is 1673.1328. And you can use this same formula to calculate area of any polygon, area of any piece of land if you have the correct coordinates. So you can as well use Civil 3D to confirm that. So in Civil 3D, have this. Go to measurement tools, choose area, and make sure that the snapping tool is on, or the node and the center is on. Then so then click enter, and from the quick report you can see that area is equivalent to 1672.13. So guys, that's how you can use Excel to calculate area of a piece of land in Excel. So thank you for watching. See you in the next tutorial.